Good morning, Calvary Chapel. Happy resurrection. Today is a resurrection day. Oh, can I get a witness of those who are excited in the house? You know, wherever you are, can I please ask you to be on your feet? Because the resurrection today should bring a shaking in your body. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And today, wherever you are, I just want you to know that Jesus is alive. Oh. I didn't hear you. I said Jesus is alive. And because he lives, we can face tomorrow. And I want to read a couple of scriptures to you. Are you ready? You know, the Bible says in Romans chapter 4, verse 25, it says he was delivered over to death for our sins. And he was raised up to life for our justification. Oh, so we have been justified through his resurrection. And so Paul also said, Ephesians chapter 2, and said, you he made alive who were dead in sin and in trespasses. But then he said in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 6, he said, and he raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places. So the resurrection was not Jesus alone, but you and I who were dead and in sin and in trespasses. The Bible said he raised us up together in heavenly places. And today, the Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 11, that is my last scripture, it says, now, if the Spirit that raised Jesus from death, if it is living in you, oh, come on, say, I got the resurrection, come on, hallelujah. Somebody shake your body, let the devil know you are alive, come on, hallelujah. Are you ready with your praises shoe? Hallelujah. Now, let me repeat the scripture to you. He said, if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from death is living in you. Oh, come on. He who raised Christ from death will give you life to your mortal bodies. He will quicken your mortal bodies. He will bring a shaking. That is why the resurrection is so powerful. The Bible said that, oh, death, where is your victory? Oh, death, where is your strength? Thanks be to God who always give us victory through Christ Jesus. The Lord, can somebody shout a big amen? Say victory! You see, I want you to feel the vibration of resurrection. Because the Bible said that when Jesus rose up, the temple, the partition was torn apart from top to the bottom. Come on. Somebody give the Lord a shout of praise in the house. Are you excited in the house? I tell you, the devil is defeated. He is under our feet. And therefore, we are going to give him the highest praise in the house. Can somebody give the Lord a shout of praise? Hallelujah! And today we are living with resurrection. And today I came to bring the Lord the highest praise. Because Jesus has overcome. And because he lives, we can face tomorrow. Come on, somebody lift up your hands as we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, Father, we thank you today for the power of the resurrection, oh God. That when you died, you did not lay in the grave, but you shook the grave. And today you are alive. And therefore we praise you this morning, oh God. We worship you this morning, oh God. We thank you for our justification, oh God. We thank you that let the praises rise, oh God. Let the praises rise in the name of Jesus. Because you are our victory. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Let's all shout amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Come on, Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. Here it comes. Put your hands together with us today. your joy.
Raise your joy and triumph high. Hallelujah. Sing the heavens and earth reply. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Lives again.
Oh, lives again our glorious King.
Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, we have our national anthem, praise God, but the believer also has an anthem, praise God, and we're going to go ahead and get that started this morning. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah, God. Lord has overcome the grave. Hallelujah. Victory. Hallelujah.
Seated in majesty. Hold you down.
You are the risen King.
You are the risen King. Yes, you are.
Seated in majesty.
You're seated with all power and majesty.
You are the risen King.
Death could not hold you down. It was not strong enough to hold you. To hold you down.
You
the grave has no victory. You are the soon and coming
King.
You're seated in majesty.
You are the risen King. Death could not hold you down.
Death was not strong enough to hold you down.
Church, today we declare He is risen. Now, if you're not sure about that, this is an early church response. When the leader says He is risen, we respond by saying He is risen indeed. So one more time, He is risen.
Risen indeed.
Amen. That is our anthem today. Jesus is alive. He lives in our lives. Amen. Well, we welcome you to Easter Sunday service today. We want to take a few moments to greet one another. Would you turn around and welcome about five or six folks around you? Hug them real big and welcome them in the name of the Lord. Thank you. right. Well, we want to take a moment to welcome each and every one of you. And this morning we pray that you're going to be more than blessed. We believe that your life is going to be transformed because God transforms our lives. Amen.
Amen.
This morning we are blessed with a beautiful choir today. Woo! They look good this morning. They're going to be singing for us, "Lord, I Lift Your Name on High." They do a beautiful job of what there. Oh, my goodness. And I tell you, you take your life in your hands when you're in a choir that's that crowded and you're doing all those movements there. Some of those little ones I want to give a football helmet to real quick there. beautiful job. Thank you so much, Miss Monica. It was wonderful. Yes, he is. You know, there are so many different ways to celebrate our Lord. We come together and we're grateful to be able to worship him in song. Most of all, we want to be able to worship him with our hearts. This morning, we have something that's very special for you, and we're going to be kind of telling the story of the resurrection in a little bit of a different way. Some is going to be through the reading of scriptures. Some is going to be, as you saw, with the kids coming and singing it to you, recognizing that it was Jesus who left heaven and came to earth for you and I. And today the message that we want you to hear is the message of love. Amen. That God so loved the world that he sent Jesus, his only begotten son. And you know what? The gift of Jesus is for every single one of us. For everyone who believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. Today we're blessed to be able to be joined with a mime ministry who's they've been here with us one time in the past, and we are blessed to have them again. We're going to use the yellow mic here, Mark, for just a moment if we could. Would you welcome with me from SonChaser Mime Ministries, Crystal Hobart, as she comes. Crystal, welcome. So glad to have you today.
Thank you. Thank you. I tell you, it's a real privilege to be back here ministering at the very church where we were married. So God took us 3,000 miles to meet each other, even though we only grew up about 150 miles away from each other. So that's God, and that's what he does. So my name is Crystal Hobart, and my husband and I founded SonChaser Ministries, and we are a performing arts organization. Our goal is to preach the gospel to the lost, edify the local church, and use words if necessary. So we have looked all throughout Scripture, and you can go throughout Scripture and see that God's word is living, God's word is active, God's word is dramatic, and he used so many different ways to be able to share his love with the world. And so that's what we believe that we are called to do, and we have some very exciting opportunities for you to be able to partner with us in prayer, as well as through giving, which Pastor Sean will talk about in just a few minutes. Our first is we are hosting our fifth annual Release Worship Arts Camp in the Outer Banks of North Carolina. Who doesn't like the beach? Yeah. I do. I love the beach. Uh-huh. So, of course, we go down there and do camp, and I rarely ever see the beach, but that's okay. Knowing that it's there is just awesome. So what this is a week-long camp that is geared towards rising 6th through 12th graders, and we take them through a very intensive time of training. These are kids who want to use their talents to be able to share the gospel with those around them and also to be able to expand their horizons and their talents, maybe even dabble in some things that maybe they're maybe not quite used to. So we do dance, we do drama, we do mime, there's instrumental music, there's vocal music, and some creative writing. And so we train them all week long in their chosen talent, and then at the end of the week, we go out into the community in the Outer Banks, and we share the gospel with the lost. And then that Friday night, we come into the local church at Liberty Christian Fellowship, and they allow us to do this. We have the kids take over the Friday night service at their church. And let me tell you, God blows the roof off the place, because by the end of the week, these kids are amped, they've done their evangelism, and now they get to experience what it is to minister to the body of Christ. So it's a twofold thing there. And God just shows up in a powerful way. We have evening services with them every night, and God just rocked the place last year. We had kids by Thursday night who were being filled with the Holy Spirit and praying for each other, receiving their prayer language, and just on their faces, just crying out to God. I just could just stand there and just soak it all in. I was just, there's nothing left that I could do. I'm like, okay, it's yours. You showed up. This is it. And then I had the Friday night service the day after that, which was just phenomenal. And being able to, some of these kids are being praying for people for the very first time. And so we're just excited to be able to lead them in that. So we have information on that. That is going to be July 31st to August 6th. And it's rising 6th through 12th graders again. So if you're interested in that, I'll be in the back table at the end of the service. You can talk to me. And the second thing that we have, we were here back in October. We shared with you guys about our opportunity that we have. We're going to Niger, Africa in August of this year. You guys have helped us raise some of our funds to help support that mission. We have to raise a little over $7,000. I am proud to say we are almost halfway there through God's grace. So we really want to knock this out before we start into camp season, because we start raising money for kids to be able to go to camp. So God's just done amazing things. The country of Niger is a fourth world country. I didn't even know there was such a thing. So we're talking the poorest of the poor. They rank in the top 10 worldwide for poverty. So we are teaming up with Effective Ministries, and we are going to spend a week there just sharing the gospel through what we do, which is the arts. And the beautiful thing about mime, because it's silent, is that it crosses language and cultural barriers in a way that other things can't. They have sent all sorts of different teams, from medical missions to service missions, couples, youth interns, all sorts of things, even music. But they've never sent a performing arts team to be able to go minister to these people. And I can tell you this, they are hungry. They are hungry for Jesus. This is a nation that is 95% Muslim, but the government is completely open for people to come in and share the gospel of Jesus Christ. So I am believing for the people of Niger that because their government has said, you know what? We see your ability to make a difference through sharing your faith and opening that door. I believe that God is going to pour out a spirit of revival amongst those people, and he is just going to be able to take that country for Jesus Christ. This ministry that we're teaming up with, Effective Ministries, believes within the next decade that they are going to be able to have the country of Niger be a Christian nation. And we are standing with them. We are believing for that. We are partnering with them, and we're just so excited to be able to be a part of that. So now Pastor Sean's going to be able to share with you guys about how you can partner with us specifically in that mission. And we're just so grateful to be here and to be able to minister with you on Resurrection Sunday. So this first piece, my husband gets to do all of them today because this is about Jesus. So Mary's good. She's good. this first piece that we're going to share with you really takes a look at certain characters that have shown their face throughout Christ's journey to the cross. And so we're going to take a look at these characters and kind of see how the cross affected and changed them to the point where they were trembling.
When they crucified my Lord, were you there? When they crucified my Lord, oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to a tree? Were you there when they nailed him to a tree?
Chris is going to come back with one more special later on in the service. But this morning we're going to join together some of the hymns of the faith. This morning I'm going to invite you to stand and sing with us one of my all-time favorites, Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow. Come on, let's worship the Lord together.
Heal and forgive. Stars. I hear the
Oh, we give him praise. Today, Lord, we give you praise. Can I tell you today that not only is our God great, but his love for you is awesome today. All that he did was because of his love for you and I. You know, the power of our God, it's literally impossible to stand in the light of his power, in the light of his grace. On Good Friday, we read the scripture and we saw how when the guards came to seek Jesus, they came with Judas, who betrayed him. And Jesus stepped forward to the guards and said, Who do you seek? They said, Jesus of Nazareth. And he simply said, he stood forth and said, I am. And the Bible says this, that the guards fell backwards and fell to the ground with the power of his name. As we sing that, the name above all names, I want you to know today that your God is an awesome God. When he rose up from the grave, the Bible says on that, early that morning, as the guards surrounded that tomb, that as the angels came something began to happen, something began to shake, the ground began to shake. And the Bible says this, the guards fell to the ground as dead men. I want you to know that this was a rough weekend if you were a Roman guard. You started out falling down in the garden. You ended up by laying down like you were a dead man, all because of the power of God. Today, I want you to know that power does not push you away, but that power draws you by his love. For he was on a mission to seek and to save that which was lost. That's every single one of us. God's love is for you today. Do this with me this morning. I know many of you have come in since we began today. Turn around to two or three folks you haven't seen yet today. Let them know that God's love is for you today. Wish them a happy Easter today in Jesus' name. Oh, bless God. Well, we welcome you this morning in the name of the Lord. We're so glad that you're with us today. Whether this is your normal church home or you're visiting today, we want you to know that we want you to feel like family in the house today. We're not an organization, not a business, but we are the family of God together. So those that you just grabbed hands with and shook hands or hugged their neck, you might have been meeting some brand new family today, because God brings us in as sons and daughters of the King. Amen? Amen? All right. Now, you're a quiet crew this morning. I want you to know that in Calvary Chapel, you're allowed to talk and shout back a little bit. All right, there you are. I knew you were here this morning, but bless God. We have one more song this morning coming from our SonChaser Ministry team. And as we recognize that as Jesus walked the earth, you know that most folks didn't realize in the very beginning that he was the Son of God or the Messiah. Mary knew. Mary had had a visitation from an angel, but most of them just saw him as the carpenter's son. He was Jesus. He grew up, and they all knew him just as a semi-normal kid. He did some odd things at 12 years of age, hanging around the temple with the adults. But there was a mission that he was on, and you and I are the mission. This song says, no one knew his secret ambition. Chris, let me welcome you to come back, if you would. Welcome him one more time. Secret ambition. Go ahead, Mark.
Nobody knew his secret.
Bless God. Secret ambition was to give his life away for every single one of us. We are the joy that was set before him. I got to tell you something today, that the good news of the gospel is that Jesus is alive, and because he's alive, you and I are alive with him today. So I want to declare to you again, he is risen.
He is risen.
Amen. Well, today, as we said, we're so glad that each and every one of you are with us. You've received a bulletin as you've walked in the door. Our bulletins let you know what's going on through the week. And while we're extremely glad that you're here today, our greatest prayer is that you would come and be connected and be part of the church family. As God brought forth his love for us, it's not just for an Easter Sunday, but it's for us to live in that love of God. How many of you would say that God has made a difference in your life? He's changed your life. We invite you to come and get on a journey with us, because what we're doing is we're on a journey in Jesus together. Our lives are constantly being changed by his power. Now, you can look through the various things that are going on. We do have a video clip we're going to show you. Hopefully you guys have been able to change over to the sound of the computer back there. We're going to, I'm going to stall while they're remembering they have to do that. It was just one of those quick hints. It's amazing because you guys are all facing this way, and I'm looking and seeing everything else that's going on in the service. So we even see when you go out to the bathroom. Oh, it's a. We have an incredibly special event that's going on this Thursday night. And if you haven't done this with us yet, I want to invite you. There's still a number of tickets that are available. But if you've noticed, there have been a number of movies that have been released over the last year that have glorified the life of Jesus and the life living in us. One of those movies are getting ready to come out for release next Friday. We have a special showing. We have rented out a theater in Hoyt's Nursery Road. It's just about 10 minutes up the road from here. And we have a special discount of tickets. If you went on a night, you would normally pay $11.25. Because we have rented out the theater, our tickets are $7 a piece. So you save $4.25 per ticket. So it's great to be able to come and bring family and bring friends out to. Not only that, but then after the movie plays, we have the theater for about 15 minutes, and we're able to share the gospel and pray with one another. So it's a great opportunity to share the love of Jesus, even if you're a little bit nervous of sharing it yourself. Give somebody a free movie ticket this week. It's amazing how folks will come to the movies. You might even want to buy them a thing of popcorn if they come with you. God's Not Dead, number 2, coming this Thursday.